Yeah. You live?
Yeah.
I'm in. Can you talk real quick?
Yeah. How's everybody doing?
Hey, guys.
I'm right here with my boy, Ben.
What's up, guys? Hey, so in America, I almost never wear a mask because they're pointless in most situations. But in acute situations where you're around really sick people, masks work, or they make sense. This one actually doesn't do much. It's more virtue signaling. I've got a better one in there, but I had a hard time breathing in it. But we're in a place where it's not COVID. I'm actually not even worried about COVID, but here you have tuberculosis, heavy counts of tuberculosis, yellow fever, and even reports that possibly the bubonic plague that we had down in Skid Row may have come from the border. So this is a place where a mask actually makes sense, not where Joe Biden has it while he's walking his dog by himself and he trips over his dog.
Now, let me ask you a question.
Look at this. Hang on. We got the Joe Biden flag.
Look at this. Let me ask you a question, Ben, before, and that is a good person to be at, I already did an interview with her. And let me ask you a question. Now, this is all provoked by some guy that opened his mouth and said, we're going to create a better pathway for migrants. And this, what is your impression right here as you see it right now?
Yeah, no, this is a disaster. I mean, it's a disaster created by the Democrats, the same leftist groups, El Otro Lado, Pueblo Sin Fronteras, Centro Sin Fronteras, these groups that are in Mexico saying everyone's welcome. They're in Central America. They're around the world saying all you have to do is get to America. And we will provide everything you need because America's a rich country and America doesn't deserve all this wealth. This is a direct outgrowth of that. This is the globalist, communist, socialist, anti-American, anti-Western philosophy is created by this. And the saddest part is there are people, like, I get it. Life sucks in Central America because of the corruption, because of the socialism, because of the governments down there. But the solution is not to flood America. It's to help people where they're at. That's why missions work does a lot of work in these countries. That's why missionaries have been in Mexico for years. That's why good churches actually do a lot of good work. This is designed to undermine American sovereignty and to undermine America, the system of America. And it's by design. It's by the leftists. It's created by them, these open borders leftists. They know what this is going to do to America.
Yeah. And, you know, there's a bill that it was going to be passed by President Trump that it was $4.8 billion to help people in Central America, to boost the economy and to build a better infrastructure. But that Donald Trump was going to send a task force to actually prove that they were going to invest that.
Right.
And Joe Biden is going to send that money, but without no task force, Ben.
Right. That's exactly what we've always seen. We're wasting, as Americans are dying, as the businesses are dying because of the idiotic shutdowns we've had in America. Thank you for Mississippi and Texas reopening. You should have never shut down. None of these states should have shut down. While we're doing that, Joe Biden's going to take billions more of our tax dollars and send it to Central American, South American countries with no oversight. And that's been the problem from the beginning. That money goes to the corrupt leaders in those countries and they spend it however they want, make the situation even worse. And again, like, I'm all for helping other countries if we want to as individuals, if I want to donate to a charity or to a Christian organization that's going to do work down there. But taking my tax dollars and burning it. Well, think about this too. While we're shutting down border wall construction and undermining American sovereignty at our border, spending millions of dollars a day on canceled contracts to these contractors, we're going to spend more of our dollars sending down to Central America where it's just going to be wasted. It's crazy.
Okay, so let us just walk. I'm going to change the camera right here with everybody. How's everybody doing? God bless the United States of America. God bless my country of Mexico, my city of Tijuana, and the United States of America. This is the situation right now. There are blankets all over the place, and it is just horrible. Because before, there was no blankets right here on the sidewalk. And now we see that there's blankets. And then you got people hanging their clothes from, you know, stop signs and no parking signs. And on the other side is more of a catastrophe because there's people that they have been waiting here for more than 2 weeks for a response. Because Joe Biden said that everybody was going to have the right to come in. Not caring about if they had an MPP number, a court date number. Everybody that got to the border was going to let in. And no surprise right now, it is just a complete catastrophe. And more than that is that we have more than 200 children right here. That is the saddest part about it. There's a humongous problem in Juarez, that is the border with El Paso, where in the month of January, they registered 5,700 children, unaccompanied children already in DHS, which they are using as a strategy to obtain the political asylum, as you were saying before, Ben. They send them to the other side of the port of entry, and then the family member arrives on the next day to the port of entry and says, hey, I want the political asylum because my son is on the other side. It is just a horrible situation. You got four families infected of COVID right here inside. And, you know, the necessity, it is really bad. A lot of people have come to me when I arrive here, Ben, and they're telling me, hey, you know, can I borrow some money for food? Can I borrow money to go to the bathroom? Because we don't have no portable bathrooms. There's no portable bathrooms. There's nothing right now where, you know, where they can do their necessities. Nobody's giving a response. No governmental official from the United States of America has come out. I confronted the United Nations in Juarez. I told them, what is going on with the globalist compact of immigration? When are you gonna give a statement? When are you gonna talk about the enormous child trafficking and the enormous unaccompanied minors they have arrived into your border? Nobody gave an answer. It is exactly the same thing right here. And not only affects the United States government right here, and it looks bad on the Biden administration, but it's affecting my country of Mexico. It is completely affecting my country. Businesses are being locked down. The taxi drivers that they were located on this particular part of the area, now they're moved over here. People are not happy of this situation that is going on. Christian churches are coming and giving out, you know, food and all that kind of stuff to help them, but they're complaining about the Mexican government and ultimately the American government, that they're saying, where is the American government, Ben? They're saying, where is it? You know, they said that they were gonna let in, and now you get this war zone that is just horrible.
And right behind us where those people are standing, you're saying that's part of the toilet because they don't have any toilets out here?
Oh, yes.
Along that wall is actually where
that's,
they're
that right the restroom? There. Yes, that right there. Right there in the back is where they're using, you know, they're doing their necessities. And also there's a plaza right here on the back where they are also, you know, they have said that they're breaking in into businesses because they need to do their necessities over there also. So there's nobody's helping. Nobody's helping. I understand that in the United States of America, there's more than 500,000 homeless veterans. There's a homeless situation in Skid Row. It is horrible what is happening in California.
And it's getting worse.
And it's getting worse. Infections and all that kind of stuff. We have a lot of homeless in Mexico. But this is a communist. It's a communist system, Ben. You bring poverty into more poverty.
Say that again.
I'm lying, people.
Okay.
This is a communist system. You bring poverty into more poverty. It is what happened. Venezuela was designed for globalists to look at as an example on how can they destroy a country, really. And it is exactly what is happening in Mexico. It is a design. It is you bring poverty into more poverty and you create just one social class. It is exactly what they're trying to do in California. It is exactly what Joe Biden and the Democratic Party want to do with the United States of America, really. They want to bring communism into their country. How are you going to bring this situation to California right now, to San Diego, California? It is just, how are you going to provide all of this? And the question that I have said, Ben, is that is the United States ready for all of this? Because if San Diego is ready to take all these people, I wonder if they have shelters, if they have places where they're going to give them food, education for their kids and their children and families and all that kind of stuff.
And it's not just these people, it's the 7 billion other people around the world that these globalists say have a right to go anywhere they want.
The Global Migration Pact. And it has to do a lot now. A lot of things are going to happen to the United States of America. The United States of America, as I have said, is under globalist attack. From this year, starting with Joe Biden, is under globalist attack. They're going to be signing also the globalist compact of the environment. That is where the environmentalists are saying that now COVID is healing the world because the manufacturers are not contaminating that much. So the carbon dioxide levels have gone down. So COVID is helping now. They're trying to make it look like it's helping now. It is ridiculous.
As we're destroying the economy.
Exactly.
These are the same people that said, the World Health Organization said, we should expect 200 million deaths from starvation because of COVID. So basically they're celebrating that.
Yes, they're celebrating that. And you know, it's part of also of China that is with this Paris deal, they want to get rid of emissions. And Xi Jinping, the dictator from China, wants to get rid of emissions and wants to lower down the carbon dioxide and carbon monoxide. So, you know, emissions from automobiles will be eliminated by 2035 and 2065. So electrical cars will come in. So that is part of the Paris deal. That is why China is interfering in a lot of countries, trying to extract lithium, trying to get all the lithium because of batteries and all that kind of stuff. So the environmentalists are now getting into all these catastrophes, Ben. the globalist compact of immigration, the globalist compact of the environment, and X is going to be the globalist compact of the education pushed by the Vatican. All of these globalization and globalist compacts, it is this. This is the result. This is the result. And I'm still waiting,
Ben. This is the first result.
This is the first result, yes.
It exists around the world in the United States. It's, like you said, it's creating two classes, a huge poverty class,
yes,
and then a small rich class, and then you can, that's where the Bolshevik revolution, all of these, the Venezuelan revolution, all of those things that you talked about,
yes,
you have to create economic catastrophe in order to get the people to move towards a socialist, a communist society.
Yes.
It's, what a tragedy. Where are they getting all these tents from? Because a lot of these tents look brand new.
Well, Hang on one second.
So Blue, where are they getting these tents from, these blankets, everything that we see out here? Because a lot of this looks new.
You know, a lot of them, as I have said before, there's a lot of nonprofits that they have been working in Tijuana, that they're good nonprofits, that they have been working here for years. As you, before the you did the interview right now, you know, a Christian church just approached me and said, hey, we need to work together and we need to help people out. Not only Mexicans, but people that they're arriving in these kind of situations. And those nonprofits are the ones that they're providing these tents. And also they're giving them blankets like this ones that you see right here on the floor. So they're the ones that they're stepping into the plate. And you see, you know, a government from the United States that provoked this because they say that they were gonna create a better pathway. But they are not here to be seen. The Commission International of Human Rights, they're not here. The United Nations, the one that created this globalist compact of immigration, they're not here. The leftists, they're not here. Nobody's here. So the people right here are really upset because ultimately it leads you to understand that they're being lied to. And a lot of them, they're right now standing and saying, where are you? You know, you told us that you were gonna let us in. You told us you were gonna give us all this, all these amenities and all these qualities of life that which, you know, there's a complete, you know, the opposite right now. And it is just, you know, it's a horrible scenario right now to see all of this, man. It's just horrible.
Let's get in there.
All right, so we're just gonna walk right here, guys. Ben, your impression?
It's not surprising at all. This is what the left does. They talk about things. It's the virtue signaling. It's the, we care about you. They only care so far as they can use you. So what I'm concerned is this is just the beginning. They're upset. Joe Biden and the Democrats are upset that Guatemala is actually doing more on their border to stop the caravans from coming up.
That's ridiculous, man. That is so ridiculous, man.
Democrats want, they don't want it just here. They want it all along the border so that they can say, everybody come in. That's the only way that you get the collapse of the economy that they want in America. They were happy. They even said that. The only way they could beat President Trump was if the U.S. economy collapsed, and they created it using COVID to shut down our economy.
It is a complete strategy. Yeah.
It's all tied together. So they don't want just this. They want more of this. So then they can say, oh, look at those poor kids. And they do it every single time. So watch, this is going to start happening probably this week in the news. Oh, look at all these poor kids down here. It's terrible how terrible America is. We have to do something about it. Open up America. And that, because they know popular opinion right now, this is a disaster for them. When they canceled the Remain in Mexico
populist government
policy,
yes.
When they canceled the Remain in Mexico policy, it was already pulling terribly in America because you've destroyed the American economy, you've shut down American jobs, and now you're saying you want to let in hundreds of thousands of more people. They had to stop. They had to slow down, and now they're stuck with, well, what do we do? So let's go talk to some of the people.
Yes. I'm holding the mic right here like you're 5'8".
Yeah, and I know. I'm not. I know. I'm like, you cut my face off, bro.
You told me. Oh, my God. He's so tall, man. So let's just walk right here.
Are you sure I'm not?
You're good. You're good. If you want an interview with some of them, they are over here. Let me just get you an interview right here with some of the people that are wearing the shirt.
So, again, you said that there's four families potentially.
Mande. Mande. Déjeme saludarlo. ¿Cómo no? Así. ¿Cómo bien? ¿Cómo está?
Señor, ¿cómo le va? Bien aquí, hermano.
¿Qué anda haciendo?
Hermano, esperando a ver si...
¿De dónde viene?
Soy colombiano.
Where you come from? And he said that he's from Colombia. ¿Cuál es su opinión en estos momentos de que Joe Biden dijo, el 19 de febrero voy a dejar de entrar de 300 en 300 en 300, y mire, no es una realidad? What is your impression right now of thinking that Joe Biden on the 19th of February, he said that he was going to let in by 300 and 300, and now it's not a reality? ¿Cuál es su impresión?
La impresión es que hay que tener, primero todo, paciencia. porque el señor presidente en este momento quiere hacer muchas cosas, pero no las puede hacer.
And the first thing that we have to think about is to be patient, because the president wants to do a lot of things, but he cannot do things all at once.
Pero hay que darle tiempo, hay que darle espera, que él resuelva muchos otros casos, porque no es solamente lo único que él tiene para resolver en Estados Unidos. Lo interesante es tener paciencia y comprender de que esta es una problemática a nivel mundial.
The thing is that we need to understand that, you know, everything needs to be handled with patience, and most importantly, that this is a world problematic. It's not just in certain parts. It's the world.
Por lo tanto, primero de todo hay que tener primero fe en Dios, segundo paciencia en este señor presidente, que es buena gente, es un ángel de Dios. El señor que había de presidente, eso era un demonio, pero Dios mandó un ángel.
He's saying that basically, you know, this president is an angel of God, man, and that he has been sent to help people, and the past president, he was a complete devil. That's what he's saying.
What caused him to come here from Colombia?
¿Qué es lo que lo trajo usted aquí para venir de Colombia para acá?
La inseguridad en Colombia, la recesión económica, las dificultades para poder vivir.
The situation in Colombia, the recession economy of Colombia, and all that is happening in Colombia, the insecurities that are happening in Colombia. Bueno, muchas gracias, jefe. Muchas gracias. Vamos a caminar un poquito más.
Si ustedes pueden publicar. Yo estoy con un proyecto de energía de litio para hacer energía.
We were talking about that right now, and he said, I'm in a project with energy of lithium. I'm in a project with energy of lithium to produce energy of lithium. This is the new business that I was just saying about the, you know, Chinese and communist political parties that they're coming, and they're implementing this idea that energy is the new substance for life.
Para hacer baterías, para celulares,
to create batteries and to create electrical cars. This is funny. What I was talking about right now in a moment.
Si hay algún, hay alguna empresa o alguna persona interesada en Estados Unidos.
If there's somebody in the United States that is interested, I'm right here.
Tengo unos proyectos muy
he has some projects that are really attractive if people want to come and hear him out. Muchas gracias, jefe. Ahorita que venga, aquí voy a andar.
Señor.
Muchas gracias.
Gracias. Hey.
Wow.
Hey.
Ahorita se lo digo, jefe, si quiere, ahorita se lo digo.
No, Skype.
So we're walking right here. How's everybody doing this? I'm right here with Ben Berquam, right here, a boy. You see, you know, a lot of people are not in the same opinion. A lot of people have faith on the President Joe Biden. A lot of people don't, as I have been interviewing, you know, people that they look at the president differently. You want to do another interview right here?
They're going to test me real quick on Skype.
You're going to test you? Okay.
All right. Give me a second. Go ahead and do whatever you want.
Okay. All right. So let us just walk right here. This is the...
In case they want to have you on, I want to have them.
Okay. All right. So I'll be right here. Okay. Walk in the middle of the street and then come back. Is that okay?
Yeah.
Okay. So this is the actual situation right now, people. This is... it's not pretty, really. It's not pretty. ¿Cómo estás? ¿Quieres ir al baño? No traes dinero para ir al baño, de seguro, ¿eh?
No puedo cargar esto, ¿vale?
Ten.
Gracias, vale.
Para que vayas al baño.
¿Todavía andas trabajando?
Todos, hasta la tarde. Hasta la tarde le vamos a dar. So this is the actual situation. ¿Qué dice? ¿Cómo estás?
Todo bien, gracias a Dios.
How are you doing? I'm asking him. Lo traduzco al inglés, ¿eh? ¿Cómo te sientes en estos momentos, en esta situación? Esta situación es precaria, es un poquito inhumana. Y pues definitivamente vemos que el gobierno de los Estados Unidos no ha salido a dar ninguna declaración y ustedes están en espera, ¿no? How do you feel right now? This is a precarious and inhumane situation. The government of the United States has not come out to give a statement. How do you feel? ¿Cómo te sientes?
Pues mira, es bien, como bien lamentable el caso y al saber que estamos en una espera que no llega. Al estar esperando una espera que no llega, es muy como bien trágico, pues no hayamos, hay tristeza y todo, no se sabe nada, no sabemos si estamos aquí, pero estamos como abandonados.
Tu percepción ahorita en este momento del presidente Joe Biden, que dice, sabes que voy a dejar de entrar de 300, pero es parece que es una completa mentira, ¿no? Lo que está diciendo dejar entrar de 300, y aquí los veo acampando todos los días en el frío y en la lluvia. Parece que es una mentira, pero pues hay la esperanza, ¿no? Your impression of Joe Biden saying that he's going to let in by 300, there's hope, but you know, it believes that it looks like it's a lie.
Pues la realidad, nosotros no sabemos nada ni nada, porque no podemos informarlos con una amplitud ni nada, sino que vuelan varias informaciones y nosotros en realidad no tenemos ni una respuesta de arriba, pues alguien que venga representando de allá que los dé una, como una esperanza, más certeza, pues que sí, los van a dar la oportunidad, y nosotros lo que pedimos es eso. La verdad que estamos aquí sufriendo porque quizás hemos sufrido más en nuestros países, y aparte que en nuestros países corremos peligro, pues eso es lo más. Entonces estamos aquí, y aquí estamos igual, aquí corremos el riesgo y todo.
He's saying that practically, you know, it's a danger to be over here. It's a danger to be in this kind of situations. And it's a complete danger to be, you know, every day right here waiting, and nobody has come out and give us a response, a solution. Nobody has talked to us. Nobody has said anything to us. Gracias, gracias. Ahorita vengo para acá. Gracias, gracias. Okay. Let's walk right here for a little bit. You see a guy right here moving around, swerving around the Biden flag. That is the Colombian that we just interviewed. And
down here is named Oscar El Blue. So if you want, I can have him on with me at the same time, and I'll let him report all of that. I'll just say where we're at, and hang on a second. Let me give him a headset. Yep. Hang on. Well, the problem is I'm not using a mic. I'm just using my headset. Oscar, can you hear?
Yes, I can hear you.
Okay, can you hear Oscar? Okay. This is Steve.
Well, the situation is that on the 19th of February, Joe Biden told the American public told the world that he was going to open up the borders, and he was going to be admitting by the quantities of 300, Steve, every day. So everybody started coming over here to this particular part that is called El Chaparral, the port of entry to the United States of America, to San Isidro, the first city of San Diego. And they started camping out, you know, 5 people, 10 people, 15 people. Until they started thinking, you know, probably if we camp out, they will listen to us. And if we camp more people out, you know, they will actually come. And nobody has come over here. It's a critical situation because you got more than 1,500 migrants camping out right here. They don't call it a protest. They call it a peaceful gathering, as they are going to the port of entry of you know, of the vehicle entrance. So yesterday they went over there. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. I live in Tijuana, Mexico. Yes, sir. Yes, I'm born and raised over here in Tijuana, Mexico. Yes, sir. This is my hometown. No. No, the majority of the people in this camp... yes, go ahead. I'm sorry. Well, you got like probably like 5 or 6 people that they are from Mexico. You know, 5 or 6 or... Yes, sir.
And Haiti.
And other parts of Nicaragua, and also Brazil. And also part of the islands, you got Cuba and Cubans over here also. Got people from Cuba also. And Venezuela, of course, Venezuela. Oh, yes. After the first broadcast that I did, that it was last week, it was, yes, on the far right side right here, there is the priority line where you ask for the political asylum. After you get to this particular part, what is the plaza for the entrance to the pedestrian walkway, it grew immediately from one day to another. And you know, they started growing because people started thinking that he was going to let in everybody, not people that they have specifically a legal process or an appointed court date, that is the MPP. Everybody started coming in. As I have interviewed people, they said Joe Biden told everybody to come in. He didn't say an appointed court date. He didn't say, you know, this particular individual or that one. He said everybody. That's why we're camping out right here. I'm a local media guy. I'm a broadcaster and a reporter over here in Tijuana, Mexico. Oscar Blue and Border Network News right here. You see it right here. Yes.
Border Network News.
Yes, sir. When the first caravan came in 2015, it came with 15,000 migrants of 2015. And when it first started, it was people started getting a little bit scared, and they said, you know, there's a lot of necessity in Haiti. There's a lot of necessity in these particular parts. Then they started coming, you know, roughly and hardly and violently. So they said, oh, this is coming over here. So when they started camping out, people were not accepting it. The number one reason why is the levels of increase of violence and delinquency, you know, they increase graphically, you know, decrease enormously. And not only that, you know, you got a lot of child trafficking involved in the caravans. And there's a lot of, you know, misorder in these caravans. And it affects a lot of the businesses, the local businesses and the local people that they don't appreciate, you know, the disorder and also the enormous situation that is happening with all of this.
Yeah. Yes. Yeah. So what they do is they basically come in. They come in at night. They say we can get you across if you pay us, and then they take them out east where the or west over here, and they've got the ladders set up so all over the place, and they take them and cross them illegally for the people that have enough money to pay them to do it. So we're sharing the only way I can do this the way we're set up on Skype is either I can do it with the audio on the phone. I don't know if I'd be able to hear you. Otherwise, we're using my Beats headset. So I don't know if it... Okay. Okay. Ramirez?
This is Oscar El Blue. That's okay.
Or he goes by Oscar El Blue. Border Network News.
Yeah. Yes, sir.
And you'll like this.
No, it's just independent.
He's independent. He does a lot of work with us. He's my guy down here in Mexico. He's the guy that takes me to Guatemala. And
good to meet you, Mr. C. Bannon.
We've got a Biden flag. There's actually more Biden flags and T-shirts down here than I saw during the entire campaign. Okay. Yeah, I will.
Oh yes,
that's it,
you
right
know,
now.
Absolutely.
This is the biggest Biden rally.
Yes absolutely, and it is the biggest shirt rally also.
It's about to be the biggest Biden protest because they realize the guy's totally inept. Okay. Sounds good.
All right. So should I take this off or what's up? You want me to take it off?
Doesn't matter.
Okay. So
I think it's good if you keep it. Yeah, I got you, Arthur. Okay. We'll probably stay right here.
So we're an interview with Mr. Steve Bannon. He's a really nice guy right here with Ben. Right here in a few seconds. Where is it going to be, Ben? Or is it going to be live or not?
Yeah, it'll be live on Real America's Voice. So on Dish Network and Roku and Pluto and all of that. Now you can download the app on your phone.
Sara, sí, para atrás. Entonces, si quieres, ahorita, en 10 minutos. So we're going to go in an interview with Mr. Steve Bannon.
Incredible video.
For you guys to go over there and watch.
Okay.
It's going to be on America's.
10 minutes.
No, en 10 minutos.
Okay.
En 10 minutos. Ahorita en 10 minutos. En 10 minutos. Ahorita en 10 minutos. So we're going to be live right here in 10 minutes with Mr. Steve Bannon right here with Ben. Ken, Ben, where can they see it so I can finish the live feed?
Real America's Voice News, Dish Network, channel 219, 214 or 219. Well, just go on Dish Network, you'll find us. And then Roku, Pluto, Hulu, Apple TV, Fire TV, all of the digital platforms will be on there. And everywhere that Steve Bannon is live, War Room is playing. He's like the 28th largest in the world now, his podcast. So all over the place. But Real America's Voice News.
By the way.
And then if you download the app on your phone, just do it America's Voice News.
By the way, your privilege is showing right here in the middle of all these people.
You know.
What are your thoughts on Coca-Cola?
I'm trying to be less white. I'm trying to be less white, bro.
Like Coca-Cola?
Hang on. Let me get some of that sun. Is it working?
Yeah.
Is it working?
Yeah, you're brown. You're brown. You're a little bit brown. So you guys want to go.
I know.
And I'm Mexican. So we are going to go live right now, like in around 10 minutes with Steve Bannon. Thanks so much for watching, guys. You know, this is a horrible situation right here. This is not, it grew, the tents are growing, and the situation is not getting, better. As you guys are seeing right here, look at this, man. This is, how can you say this is good? Where's the creation of the better pathway by the new administration of the president? We are trying to say that. God bless you guys. Stay safe. And like we always say, people. Oh, follow my partner, Real Anthony Agüero. You can follow him at his page at Orbeez. Also, Facebook, YouTube, Parler. And also, you can follow him at, at his Telegram channel. You can follow me as Oscar L. Blue and Facebook, YouTube, and also my channel at Telegram. It's a pleasure to be with you guys. Stay safe. And like we always say, people, peace. Let me say, Ben, let's say the last words, peace and love.
Peace and love, and always your country first.
God bless.